Welcome. My name is Jen, and this is Chair Mind Body Connection. So we're going to start on a chair and just take a couple minutes and just kind of decompress. Everything else from the outside world gone. Don't worry about it. It'll be there in 45 minutes. Don't fret. So find a chair. It can be any type of chair you want, as long as it doesn't have wheels. And if for some reason it does have to have wheels, just make sure that their wheels are locked somehow so they won't go anywhere on you. I'm gonna try the best I can with my voice today. Since I canceled last week, I didn't want to cancel again this week. Or have a repeat, I should say, not cancel, but my voice is kind of gone and having some nice sinus stuff going on, so I'm gonna do my best. Try to project as much as I can and see what the next 45 minutes brings. So we're just going to go through a bunch of stretches. That way, if you're hot, you won't build up too much heat. If you're just looking for a way to just stretch everything out, you had a busy weekend, you did a lot of fun stuff, you did a lot of not so fun stuff, your body is a little stiff and sore, things will kind of feel better for you. So about another minute of just nice deep breaths. Can breathe through your nose, breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. Let's take our arms, just cross it over, lean forward a little bit, and just let that head hang. And look a little bit to one side. And a little bit to the other side. Back down to the ground, stretch, relax, really drop that head. Take one arm and just drop it down and just swing it back and forth. Let's do some circles, one direction. And the other way. All right, let's come on up and switch sides. So just swinging that arm forward and back.
direction, moving from the shoulder. And the other one. And then rolling on up. Let's turn all the way to one side. Nice stretch right here. And the other way. Come back to the middle. Let's take that hand, bring it to the side of the head, just the weight of the hand pushes down. A little bit more of a intense stretch if you want it. And let's release and do the same thing on the other side. Come back to the center. Big rolls. Other way. Let's come over the top side stretch. And let's chip other side. Come on up, spinal twist with those knees together. So I'm taking my right hand, bringing it over to my left leg, and bringing my left arm behind. Nice and straight back, little twist. Switch that other side. And back to the center. Let's bring one knee in. Big squeeze. I just have my heel of that foot on the chair. I can drop my head down if I want, or I can keep it up. And let's switch it out to the other side. Release. I'm going to scooch forward a little bit and I'm going to do some little hip rainbows with one leg. So obviously I can't do a big circle seated. We'll do circles when we stand in a minute, but we're going to do just kind of up and over. Warm up that hip joint a little bit. And I'm just kind of doing a little over. I'm not going all the way open here. I'm just a little bit. Let's switch it to the other side. All right, let's switch back to the first side and let's just point and flex that lower leg. Or extend and flex. working that knee, making sure there's no some little crimps and cracks or something like that is fine, as long as it's not painful for you. And if it is painful for you, then obviously we're not going to do it. Alright, let's switch to that other side. Plus, we have to keep that quad lifted, contracted, so we get a little bit of movement here, a little bit of heat. That leg down, and then we're just going to do some, you can sit back a little bit on your seat, and some pointing, some flexing, some circles, all that lovely stuff. The ankle. And let's switch out. Let's just do the same thing with our elbows. So up and down, warming up the elbow. We're not really warming up the elbow as much as warming up the biceps. But there's also a lot of little tendons and ligaments and that work in that joint, so getting those all moving. And then moving around the wrists. Okay. Drop those feet. Let's come a little further forward. And let's bring those knees relatively wide. Bring your elbows to your thighs. And we have a nice straight back here. And by me just leaning forward and pushing my hips back, I feel a nice little back stretch. If you don't feel it just yet, just kind of move around, move forward, back, left, right, do what you need to do, and see maybe do you feel it too. Now I'm going to lean a little bit, I'm going to drop one shoulder. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to come back to the center. I'm going to bring side A, whatever side A is, and bring that hand to the ground or to a prop. So that hand is just on my thigh. Let's switch it out. Come back to side A again. This time, instead of leaving this hand on the thigh, you can bring that hand behind your back and rotate more, or you can bring it up to the ceiling, whatever seems more comfortable for you. And now let's switch sides. And whatever hand position you did on side A, do your best to do that same hand position on side B. So you're either here or up here. And come back to the center. Keeping both hands down nice and low. And holding it here for about 5 seconds. Okay, rolling on up. Beautiful. Let's cross one leg over the other. and really try to make this instead of having this leg up here, try to bring it down as much as you can. Obviously, everyone's body is going to be different. I'm going to put a slight amount of weight here. That's fine. I'm going to point those toes directly forward, and I'm going to lean on it. Come on up. If you can cross over, please do so. Otherwise, stay where you are and lean forward one more time. Put a little pressure here if you want and point those toes forward. And then come on up. Cross that leg over if you can. Lean on back to square one, and that's final twist. One more time, maybe we can go a little bit more. If you want to cross the leg over, that's fine. And switch. Back to the center. So in the past, we've done our ABCs with our legs moving from our hip. Today, we're going to do them from our shoulders. So we're going to do one side at a time, and you want to make sure that you're tracing the letters of the alphabet very big, maybe just making sure that you have enough room side to side. So like I'm doing my A, I'm coming up and down and crossing over. So I have all range of motion within that shoulder. I'm going to do everything to the best of my ability. I'm going to do side A and side B. If you're like, Jen, I don't want to do the shoulders, my shoulder hurts, I don't have enough range of motion, whatever the reason is and you don't want to do it, you can also do them with your legs instead. So not a problem. I'm going to do upper body. But if you want to do lower, that's totally fine. And in order to do lower, you're just going to slide forward. I'm going to straighten out that leg. And you're going to do your letters of the alphabet from the hip. Unless you have your knee bent, you're still gonna move from the hip, which is gonna reduce the load. So we're gonna take our time. We're not in any big rush. I want you to finish each letter. We're not doing any sort of cursive type of situation. Each letter is its own entity. And we'll take a minute before we go from side A to side B so everyone can equal out. All right, so I'm gonna start with the side just cause. And let's go. Take breaks if you need to. If you can do that without your shoulder burning, more power to you, because I cannot. So give a couple seconds here for everyone to catch up. All right, and let's start Hasanasana. Out. Some big breaths in, some big breaths out. And then we're going to stand on up. So take your time. However you want to get there is fine. We're going to do those hip circles from the hip standing so we can get a nice full rotation. So we did those kind of upper rainbows. We're going to do a lower rainbow first, and then we're going to see what we can do for a relatively full circle. Okay, so I'm just going to hold on for balance, whatever seems good. And then you're going to bring a leg behind, and we're just up and over, up and over. Sound good? All right, holding on. Let's go. I'm gonna hold on. All right, let's switch sides. One more. Okay, and release. Now, obviously we can't do 100% full circle because this leg is in the way. But we're going to hold on. We're going to bring a leg as far across as we can. Come up and bring it as far across as we can. So we're going to do that all the way. All the way is one. We're going to do five. So, yet again, nice, slow, and controlled. So we're going to start right across our leg. We're going to come up around and up around. That's one. Two. So now we're going to stay on this side, and all we're going to do is we're just going to kick a little bit out to the side and do little pulses. So make any sort of adjustments you need to, shake it out. Holding on to balance, up nice and tall, and let's come back to the side for one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and rest. Shake out that supporting leg. And we're going to switch over and do everything on the other side. So you can go to the side of your chair, adjust as need be. We're going to cross the other leg over. And let's go to the back. front row on. Two. Ready for those pulses? Alright, standing up nice and tall. Let's go for one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Beautiful. Okay, switch back to side A. We're going to do those pulses to the front, and we're going to do those pulses to the back on side A, and then we'll do side B. So all we're doing is just kicking just like we kicked here. We're just going to move in this plane here. So we're going to go forward, take a second, and then do the back. Obviously, this hip is working, but this leg is also stabilizing. Are we ready? Let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Take a second. The same thing behind, and go for one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and walk it out, shake it out. We're gonna do the other side. I like to roll through my foot. So if my foot is here, I like to kind of roll through and back, really stretch out the top of that foot. Even though we didn't really work the top of the foot, it just feels so good. All right, ready? We're gonna go forward. Up nice and tall, holding on for balance. And let's go for one. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Shake it up. And behind. Four, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and down. All right, one more thing before we sit down. We're going to do the scapular retraction push-ups. So all you're going to do is come to the back of your chair or a wall or something like that. And we're just going to have our hands here, and we're just going to come and bring ourselves forward and back. So our arms are going here and back. We're not actually doing any sort of actual push-up. We're just retracting those scapulae, which are these big bones right here. We're going to pull them back and then forward. So we're gonna do 20 of those. So take your time. If you need to stop after five, take a breath, do five more, whatever you need to do. Nice, slow, and controlled, 20 repetitions. So if I'm gonna do it on the wall, my hands are here, I'm just gonna come in and back out. I could do them with my hands here, I could do my hands here. I can do wherever I want to be. I can even have my hands just up in the air and just do that motion. So whatever floats your boat, I think I'm gonna use the wall. All right, so I'm gonna go three, four, five, six,
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and then my arms are going to come down, and I'm going to have a seat. That felt okay. I'm gonna have a seat. We're gonna step nice and tall, or have our backs completely against the support, so you're up nice and straight. Take 5 breaths here. You probably guessed it, all those exercises with the legs, now we're going to do them with the arms. So we're going to start out, we're going to do our pulses to the side, our pulses to the front, and our pulses to the back, all on the same arm. If you decide that you want to switch back and forth, that's totally fine. But I'm going to do them all on one arm, and I'm going to switch to the other side. So all I'm going to do is just, I'm going to pulse out and do the pulses there. You can go up a little higher if you want, but I would not probably go above here. All right, you ready? Let's go for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. To the front, so my palm is facing behind me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. And now my palm is facing forward. Now let's go for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. Shake it out. Let that arm rest. Other side, to the side first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. All right, palm facing back. Let's go forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. And then palm facing forward. Let's go back for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Release, shake it out. All right, so now back to side A. I want you to kind of have your arm tucked in like a chicken wing. So what we're going to do is circle forward and circle back. I'm going to mimic those circles we did on the legs. All right, let's go forward. Back for 1. We're going for 10. 2, 3, 4. 5,
other side, chicken wing that arm. And let's go four. Shake those arms out. Last bit, the neck. So we're just going side and up, other side and up. So like a little pendulum, and we're going slow. For one. And two. Three. And 10. Let's drop that chin down. And then come up and point that chin forward. Stretching all over here. Come back down. And point it up. And down. Three more times. Come back to the center. Let's bring a huge circle with those arms and lean forward. Let your upper body just relax. Let those arms hang. Let that head hang. Roll on up. Again, big circles, lean forward. Relax and hang. And roll up. Three more. Big circles. Lean forward. And up. Lean forward. And up. Last time we're going to hold it a little longer. Come on up. Lean forward. Get comfy. Bring that one knee in, give it a big hug, cool it down. You want to do a spinal twist here by hugging in on the opposite arm and doing a twist. If that feels comfortable for you based on the space that you have, that's fine. If you're like me, not for me, that's fine. You just stay here in the front. If you're on a little bit of a wider seat, that would be a little bit more practical than a more narrow, of course. Same thing, if you want to twist, you can. if there's anything that your body is particularly craving, feel free to do that now. Otherwise, we're going to go into our kind of final relaxation bit. And if you ever always want to change positions, go to the floor, go to your bed, go to our couch, anything like that for this final bit, that's totally fine. Otherwise, we are going to spend 3 minutes in total silence trying to relax our body as much as possible and go into the position that feels good for you. So I'm going to just tuck my knees under a little bit. I'm going to close my eyes and I'm not going to say anything for 3 minutes. Okay, so I welcome you to stay here as long as you feel comfortable, but it is 12 o'clock noon, so I want to give you a little timestamp. Thank you so much for joining me today. Have a great rest of your Monday, and I'll see you.